All the things that women complain men don't do for them, that men don't complain about. You know, you don't have men coming into this counselor's office saying, gee, the only time she touches me is when she wants sex. Yeah, women will say it. She'll say, the only time he touches me is when he wants sex. And as a guy, I'm thinking, well, what's wrong with that? But you don't say that as a therapist. You nod your head and say, well, tell me about that. And you learn. But I went in back in those days, found out that why women are so into affection and touching, hugging, compliments, affection, touching. It's just basic stuff that men stop doing quite often in marriages. Is because those hormones just put men to sleep. But those are the hormones that stimulates the hormone that actually lowers stress in women. And the hormone that lowers stress in men is testosterone. If I'm anticipating success, I'm releasing my I'm using my testosterone. That will lower stress for me. And if a woman is anticipating being nurtured, being loved, being understood, being touched, being seen, just the anticipation of that, women's oxytocin levels will start rebuilding, 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 rebuilding. Now, as she's rebuilding her oxytocin, it still doesn't lower her stress. What lowers her stress is using up her oxytocin. And how do you use up your oxytocin? You nurture others. You think, what can I do for you? And what can I do for you? Oh, well, I'm going to give you a compliment. Oh, you need help walking crossing the street. Let me help you. Let me help you. Women's like little antennas all the time. What else can I do for you? What else can I do for you? Oh, and then we see a woman in love. Oh, my gosh, all she thinks about, what else am I going to do for him? What am I going to do? What am I going to do? Mother for their children. Your design, your brain is designed. Your reward system as a woman, it's built in. It's hardwired, and it's not there in men. Your reward system is if I nurture others, my stress goes down, and I feel great. That's if I'm nurturing others. Now, nurturing others is serving others, being there for others. When you're there for others, you're using up your oxytocin. But what happens when you've used up all your oxytocin? Your brain is still saying, and now your stress levels are getting higher. And your brain says, oh, if I'm stressed out, let me do something nice for someone. Let me bake some cookies for the neighbors, for my children, my grand. Let me plan something to make my husband happier. So she starts giving when she's under stress. So what do you find out? What's the biggest complaint, the number one complaint that women have over and over and over when they're thinking about leaving a marriage or when they're unhappy in their marriage, long before they're unhappy in their marriage? They'll say, I give and I give and I give and I don't get back. And you say, what's your biggest problem? I give too much. Women say that with badges. I give too much. I give too much. And guy going, why would you give too much? It doesn't make sense to me at all. And I'm saying it right now. It doesn't make sense unless I understand your hormones. When women are nurturing others, there's a huge release of oxytocin. As a matter of fact, if I nurture my children, there's only a little oxytocin that gets released. Men need oxytocin too, but not too much. And if we get little, we're sitting on the couch. We can easily get it. We just ask you to do something for us. We'll get our oxytocin. Whenever someone is doing something for you, your oxytocin levels start to build up. Whenever you're giving to another, you use up your oxytocin, but the reward of using up your oxytocin is your stress levels go down. So when you're stressed, what does a smart woman do? She starts giving and giving and giving.